interconnectivity and training routes. The people of Sebei region are extremely grateful to our President, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni and the NRM government for the construction of Miembe Kapchorwa Farm Road. This is a very important road and has become very instrumental in athletics training and socio-economic transformation of this region. However, to provide for more training experience, both in the lowland and highland, we request for the following roads to be taken up by UNRA and upgrade to Boatman standard to facilitate long distance running. One is Barawa Jeptecho Taryet Road, opposite Union, which is 4 kilometers. Gamatui Tangwen Ngasire Tukwoti Road, 11 kilometers. Taryet Kakwimin Road, which was meant to be an outlet of this high altitude training center, and it is equivalent to 11 kilometers. In Kwen, we have Atar Pugema Road, which is 26 kilometers. Atar Ngariomwa Road, 2.515 kilometers. Taryet Likil Road, 3.5 kilometers. In Buko, Kapkoro Sindet Marambach is 9 kilometers. Then we have Buko Kapnandi Wirwat, which is 18 kilometers. Then the other one is Kortek Jesmat Mogoyon Road, which is 15 kilometers. Mama, as we are all aware, Sebei sub-region is endowed with the talent of athletics and other sports. On behalf of the people of Sebei sub-region, I know we are always very proud when we get gold medals. My people of Sebei sub-region are requesting that government gives them a special consideration and offers at least 200 million shillings per district for tapping talent. Because whichever talent that we have seen and whichever gold medal we see today, all those medalists have been hustling alone up to the level they are, and government picks up from there. But otherwise, if we are given a special grant to tap talent, we shall have medals in thousands being produced by Sebei sub-region. Mama, we as Sebei sub-region, we are facing a challenge on the school facility grants for developing schools. There is inadequate infrastructure in both primary and secondary schools in this sub-region. In Kapchorwa district, the classroom pupil ratio is at 1:86, stands pupil at 1:62, desk pupil ratio is 1:6, and 14 primary schools are without teachers' staff houses. Out of 26 schools, 6 sub-counties without government-aided secondary schools, and 39 parishes without government-aided primary schools. Kawawa SS has no library and laboratory. So, Mama, people of Kapchorwa are requesting that if we can consider developing Kawawa SS with a laboratory and a library for the good of our learners. In Kapchorwa Municipal Council, the classroom pupil ratio is at 1:75. Then the stance is at 1:71. Pupil ratio of desks is at 1:6. And 12 out of 16 schools do not have teachers' houses. 17 wards without government-aided schools, primary schools. St. Paul captures on the seat, and Kapchorwa Senior Secondary School needs science laboratories, examination halls, more classrooms, and toilets. In Kwen District, the classroom pupil ratio is at 1:88 and the stances are at 1:163 and then the desk one is at 1:116. Some schools in Greater Benet that were affected by Hua are still in mud and water. And therefore the people of Kwen are requesting that if government can consider putting up infrastructure which is permanent for that community of Benet, such that they can be proud like any other Ugandans, and in Kwasir Primary School. In Bukwa, I think the classroom pupil ratio is at 1:89, then the stance is at 1:76, desk is at 1:6. The region has inadequate teachers' houses. Mama, there is a need for renovation and rehabilitation of existing structures across the region. There is about 6 government-granted secondary schools in Bukwa. Among them are Tulel, Kamit, Koltek, Chepwasta, Kabioyon, and Riwa, which have no permanent structures. And on behalf of the people of this sub-region, we request that they be considered for construction. The biggest challenge